Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new here. Today we're going to be doing an outdoor refresh on my deck in the back. We got some new furniture, some new plants, so I'm really excited about this one. So we're gonna start off by tidying up a little bit. I'm just putting the grill cover back on the grill where it belongs. Next, we're gonna be putting down the rugs. These were from Lowe's by the brand Allen & Roth. And I love the color of this. It's super nautical to me, which is a common theme in my household. And I thought these would look perfect out here. I got a bigger one for under the table. And then I got a smaller 5x7 one for under the sectional couch that we got. It was super windy out when we were out here putting the deck together, so you'll see stuff blowing around once in a while. But just gonna open up the other rug now, and my little buddy Jeffrey helped me out a little bit. I had him take the plastic off. I like to have them try to help me out if they want to. I think it's super cute. Something so simple to us is such a big deal for them, and it's so fun to see the excitement in their face when you ask them to help you. And here are the rugs. I absolutely love the fabric. Super high quality, and it feels like it's gonna last for a good amount of time. So this is where the dining table with the chairs is going to be. So I'm putting the bigger rug down right there. And then where I put that smaller rug is where our little sectional couch is going to go. This dining set we got when we first moved into our first home, which was almost 4 years ago. So it's got some wear to it, but I think we're going to try to get one more season out of the chairs. The table is fine, but these chairs are getting kind of worn, and we're gonna need some new ones, I think, in the near future. And also this umbrella here, you can see it's quite rusty on the bottom right there, but it still works, so we're gonna try to hold out as long as we can. So I decided to wipe the table down. It had dirt and pollen on it, and as soon as I was done, my husband told me that he was gonna bleach the tassels on the umbrella there because they are green. So I really did this for nothing because he ended up posing it all down anyways, but it was worth the effort, I guess. So he confirmed this was actually mold and mildew killer in the spray bottle. And I have to say it did a really good job. Those tassels in the end were no longer green. I also got these planters at Lowe's, just a simple white planter for these tropical little, I don't know if they're palm trees, but they're like little mini ones, and I thought they were so adorable. And I do love like a good tropical theme, and they matched perfectly for that. So I put those out there. And now we are putting together the sectional couch. I think my husband got this at Home Depot. I can link it below if I can find that link. But he got this for a good deal. He said it was initial like $800 and he got it for around $350. So more than half off. So I think that was a great deal, and it really is a nice piece. I don't know if I'd spend $800 on it. That's just a lot of money to me, but $350 was definitely reasonable for this. I think it's so funny when I'm editing these videos and I see the kids' toys that they brought into the frame while I was filming. For instance, this Mickey bike. I think it's super cute and they love hanging out with us. So they are once in a while in my videos, but they are always around. Even if you don't see them, they're always there, and I do have them help me out with some things. I like them to, you know, get that kind of experience. We're just finishing up now, putting the couch together. Just finished putting the legs on, and then there's these connectors that go on the bottom so that the couch doesn't move apart. This was fairly easy to put together. It did have a lot of screws, but we probably did it in about an hour. I've never had any outdoor furniture like this. Even, you know, growing up at my parents' house, we had nothing like this. So it's super cool to me that I have this sectional couch on my deck. And time for the cushions, putting the final pieces together. These cushions were super plush and comfortable and just really great quality. A few things that weren't included in this video that I would like to add to this deck are some string lights on the rails, and then possibly, I don't know, maybe some sort of like speaker for music. I think it'd be nice if we could have some tunes going out here while we're relaxing. And here is the couch all put together. I absolutely love this color combination, and I think it goes great with the kind of beachy theme we have going on. We decided to move the rug more under the couch, and I think that was a great choice. I think it looks way better this way. I am definitely going to be hogging the part of this couch that has the chaise on it. That looks so comfortable. I could nap there. I won't be able to because I have the kids, but it looks real comfy. Now I'm just moving one of these little, they look like little palm trees. I don't even know what they are, but they look like little mini palm trees. And just putting that next to the couch. And then here is the completed deck. Again, I am gonna get some string lights, some of like the ones like I have on my front porch, to put around the rails. But this is it for now, and I absolutely love it. I think we did spruce it up a good amount, and you know, it was super boring looking before and not really a space I wanted to be in. And now it's inviting and somewhere I want to go and spend my time. Now I'm going to be sharing a enchilada recipe with you all. It's a super quick and simple weeknight recipe. If you guys are busy and you know you don't have a lot of time, you want something quick with something tasty. So I just added a pound of ground beef and half an onion to my cast iron pan. And then I seasoned it with some cumin. I don't like to use a lot of this, it's very strong. So I just put in a little bit of that. And then the Lari's seasoned salt is my absolute favorite. So I put a good amount of that in there. Then I'm just mixing it together real good, and I'm just gonna let it cook for a few more minutes. And then while that's finishing cooking, I just grabbed some of the taco-sized tortillas, and I put those in the microwave for a few seconds. I've learned when the tortillas are warm, they don't fall apart as easily as they usually would. So I found those weren't warm enough, so I put them in for another 20 seconds. But now I'm just adding some mild enchilada sauce to the pan. I use the old El Paso one. So now I'm just mixing this all together really well, and then I'm just gonna let it all simmer in the pot for a little while longer. And now it's time to add the cheese. I just used shredded four cheese Mexican. I put a good amount into the pan. This is probably about a cup of cheese, 3/4 of a cup to a cup, I would say. And then I'm just mixing that all in really well. And then again, we're gonna let it cook in the pan for a few more minutes. Now I have an 8x11 casserole dish, and I'm just spooning the beef into the warm tortilla, and then you fold the ends together and put the seam on the bottom of the pan. I was able to fit 8 of these right next to each other in the dish. And then before you do all this, make sure you preheat your oven to 350 because we're gonna pop these into the oven for a few minutes. My 2-year-old absolutely loved these. He kept asking me for more. So definitely kid approved. Now I'm just taking that same can of enchilada sauce and just completely coating each individual tortilla with the sauce. And then we're gonna add some cheese on top. And then I pop these in the oven for about 20 minutes. The house smelled amazing after I made these. And again, a super easy dish to make and great for weeknights when you're busy. Normally, I would top these enchiladas with some fresh avocado slices, but unfortunately, I did have a few sad avocados hanging out on my counter. They were just too far gone at this point, so I did have to toss them. But I did go ahead and top it with some sour cream. I snuck a few bites in before I went to work, and I was able to give my toddlers some of this as well, and they thought it was super yummy. This even made enough where I was able to pack myself some for dinner later on that night at work. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I greatly appreciate each and every one of you. If you could please like and subscribe if you haven't already, I would absolutely love that. And I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.